Hi, I'm Michael O'Donnell, and I serve as an Extension Educator for Organic and Diversified Agriculture with Purdue Extension. In this role, I coordinate an Organic Agriculture Extension program in order to better serve the educational and technical resource needs of organic farmers and other agricultural professionals in the organic industry here in the state of Indiana. A major focus of this Extension program is related to organic grain production, so organic row crops like corn and soybean, and transitioning grain crop acreage into organic production here in the state of Indiana. A major research question in the area of organic row crop production is how can we reduce our reliance on tillage and row crop cultivation in order to improve soil health and reduce the number of passes that we're making across these fields throughout the year. So traditionally, in organic row crop systems, we rely pretty heavily on tillage and row crop cultivation, first and foremost to manage weeds in these systems, but also the tillage is used to manage cover crops that are an important part of organic crop rotations and to manage crop residues. So where in an organic crop rotation do we have opportunities to implement no-till? So we're not looking at a continuous no-till system, but a rotational no-till system. I'm standing here in a soybean field because that presents a great opportunity in order to implement a no-till phase in an overall organic crop rotation. So for organic no-till production systems, the basic idea is that we're going to seed a cereal rye cover crop in the late summer, early fall of the year preceding that soybean crop. We're going to seed it at a fairly high seeding rate, sometimes up to 150 pounds or 3 bushels of cereal rye, so that we end up with a very high biomass cover crop ahead of our soybean crop. With cereal rye, once it reaches anthesis or full flower, it's able to be terminated mechanically without the use of herbicides using a roller crimper or other types of implements that will roll down and impart a crimping action on the stem of that cereal rye cover crop that terminates it, again without the use of herbicide. That then allows us to no-till our soybean crop directly into that cereal rye. We also have the ability to no-till that soybean crop earlier into that standing cereal rye, coming back later at anthesis of that rye cover crop and terminate it mechanically. What we found after 5 years of experimental plots at the Davis Purdue Agricultural Center is that this not only has application to organic systems, but also conventional no-till soybean systems, giving us the ability to reduce our reliance on herbicides, possibly reducing all the way down to a single herbicide, post-herbicide application in conventional management systems. And if we really focus on getting a high-quality, high-biomass cereal rye cover crop, we could completely eliminate herbicides in a conventional no-till soybean crop in a given year. So this system of mechanically terminated cereal rye cover crop for no-till soybean production has applications not only in organic management systems, but also conventional management systems. It's June 1st. We are at the Davis Purdue Agricultural Center in Farmland, Indiana, in a field of cereal rye cover crop where we have replicated randomized plots for looking at mechanically terminating the rye cover crop in soybean production systems. We are running the roller crimper today. You can see 15-foot I&J roller crimper with the chevron pattern that imparts a crimp along the stem of this rye as it rolls it down. When that rye reaches anthesis, that crimping rolling action allows it to terminate. By crimping along the stem, we disrupt the flow of water and nutrients through this plant, terminating it. So we can get upwards 95%+ termination mechanically without the use of herbicide. So we're looking at this system both for in use in conventional and certified organic management systems. So in this research study, which we've had going for several years, this year we're looking at three different treatments. One where the soybeans were no-till planted into plots about 2 to 3 weeks ago into the standing sere rye cover crop. The cover crop was about at boot stage, and then we come back at full anthesis and terminate the rye with the roller crimper, and the beans are at about V1 growth stage. So they're safe, generally safe with that roller crimping action. So one set of plots we planted at boot, and then we come back and terminate the rye with the roller crimper at anthesis, and the soybeans at about V1. A second set of plots we planted when the rye was at boot, but then a day or two later sprayed it with an herbicide to chemically terminate the rye cover crop at that stage, so more of a conventional management system. The third set of plots we are also crimping today, and they will be no-till planted to soybeans, so more of the traditional of crimping and planting on the same day. We are standing in a plot that has been roller crimp terminated. The sere rye cover crop has been roller crimp terminated. We'll see how well this stays down in the coming days, coming week. But this is a plot that was already planted to beans, that was no-till planted to beans when the rye was at boot stage. And then we just rolled. So I wanted to see what this looks like. So here are the beans after being rolled, coming up through this rye. So you can see pretty pliable. We don't see any crimping in this stem. But if we go to a tire track, we'll see where some of the soybeans are damaged. So right here, this bean right at the base, tire went over it, and that stem is crimped. So that bean's probably smoked. So that begs the question, if we waited until these soybeans were fully in V1, moving on to V2, would we see less damage in these tire tracks? Because we can see where the roller is running that we're not affecting the beans, but where those tire tracks are, we clearly are impacting the beans. So here's another example. We can see, pulled a rye plant for us to look at just to show what that crimping action is doing for us. So this is a full rye stem all the way, you know, from the root that we can see there on the right and the head on the left. And you can see the two points at which that roller crimper crimped this stem. Those just fell over like that as soon as I lifted this plant up. So the idea is these crimp points that disrupts further flow of water and nutrients from this through this plant, and it should kill it. We have finished rolling these plots, and the thing that is immediately worth noting with this rye stand, thinner than we would like, given that it was seeded about mid-October. There wasn't any fertility put down ahead of the rye. We had the cooler spring, not a lot of growing units in that first part of spring when this rye was vegetative. Didn't get a lot of tillering, so not the ideal stand or ideal biomass production in the end. And we've observed over the years that when we don't hit those higher levels of biomass production, good thick stands, rye that's over your head, you know, 6-7 foot tall, that it simply doesn't roller crimp terminate as well as a thick full stand. So we can already see, if you look across here, you can see the different directions that it was rolled, but it is not flattened out. There are crimps along the stems of these plants, so we'll see what happens in the coming days following this roller crimping operation. But right now, it doesn't look too encouraging in terms of how this cover crop, the sear rye cover crop, has rolled down.